This is Cap, arguably the most eager dog around, and he'll be set on his way by Michael Gallagher, second Irish hope.
I've heard a lot of people admire this dog. Very alert looking, classic marked black and white collie. And he's run out extremely well to the right to gather his first packet of 10. And a very sweet lift. Lovely control down to the fetch obstacle. I think I mentioned it before, Barry, in commentary, but he's got a beautiful whistle, this boy.
Chip off the old block and doing rather better than either his father or his uncle. His father, Seamus, was here competing.
Just preparing for the look back. Oh, look at that, straight off. Oh, just a hesitation.
I wonder how costly that will prove. Total being set is going to be a difficult one, so he really can't afford any more errors.
That's a shame, because I did think that Cap had taken that first time, but he's setting on a very nice route now. And there he comes into a good place behind the sheep. I have to say, these sheep have been beautifully presented by the shepherds. Look at that, they're just quietly grazing. Absolutely perfect for a sheepdog to lift and bring down on the fetch. And an 800 meter fetch back through the fetch obstacle.
Having to work a bit harder on this packet than on the first packet.
Yeah, not so easy to keep on line, as they're rather flowing downhill. But he's got them nicely grouped together. This dog is so responsive to command. Every half whistle or verbal word of command is instantly taken. And he's pressing these sheep just nicely. You know, he's got a good flock there together. Well turned.
Tell me, is the greater number making it easier or more difficult?
Well, in some ways easier, because obviously the sheep are less likely to run from the dog, but harder from the point of view that the dog has to work harder to press them on and to keep them bunched together. And in a major test like this, which really is a test of a practical work dog, they're expected to keep this flock of sheep as one.
Now, in the shed, the flock is not to be kept as one. Five have to remain, the rest invited to leave.
Well, I think it would be good if it was as easy as that, Barry.
I thought you might say that. And the five, of course, have to have collars. So he's making sure that that quintet departs quickly.
There's great debate goes on as how's the best way to set about this task. I think it's generally accepted that to cut a few and then allow others to break away and join the first cut is the best process. And that was extremely neatly done. He looks like a pretty cool customer to me. He's setting about this job in a very, very confident manner.
And he's now back to the qualifying and the semi-final round in one sense, because there are two sheep to be removed. This time he's got to keep those wearing the collars.
That's lovely control of the dog. Oh, and that's proved to be successful as well. Look at that. The two are away. He's got the five. And we've seen this dog before in confrontational situations, and he's well up for it. But you just cannot be too careful. After all that good work, it could all be undone if those sheep break away and join the others. And he only has to pen them to finish his trial. Oh dear. It's tense.
Well done.
An excellent run, Barry. An excellent run. A few faults, whether it's going to be good enough, I don't know, but that was an excellent run.
Well, it's close, but not as good as the Dutchman. Dropped 9 points on the first outrun. That's 39 points on the second outrun. Remember that hesitation. That has proved.